Dear students, I welcome you to this particular presentation on tutorial on JavaScript, in which today's agenda would be to take you through the basics of JavaScript for web development. So before we get on to the JavaScript for web development, let us look into what is web development or how does it work, how does a web work. If you look into the background of it, web development is all about communication between two entities or two parties over a protocol called as HTTP, which is Hypertext Transfer Protocol. So the two parties which are involved over here are the server, which is responsible for serving pages, but for it to serve pages, somebody should request for page, and that request is basically done by a client, and generally the client we use is the web browser. Okay, so the user basically uses his web browser in order to send the details or send the request of a particular page which needs to be served by the server. So as you can see in the small diagram, you have a client and a server. Client sends in a request in the form of, it could be a URL or it could be a specific image, it could be some data which is from the required from the server, and the server respectively gets that particular data or the page and runs it back to the client. So if you look into a basic example, the general set of steps or a normal usage of steps would go about something like this. So as a user, you will open the web browser, which is the client. You will type in the URL google.com and click on send, where this particular request will go in the form of a HTTP request to the server, which is google.com. So the server then acknowledges the request, replies the client with some metadata, which is called as the headers, followed by page source. The client then receives the page source, renders it into a human viewable website, which is seen by the user. The user types in Stack Overflow, which is supposed to be a text which he has to search in the search bar, and clicks on enter. When he submits this particular data to the server, server processes the data, that is basically go about searching for Stack Overflow in any of the links which it has got, and replace back with a page matching with search results in a specific order. The client once again renders the page which was sent by the server to the user to view. So this is a typical flow of information between the client and server in any web scenario. So what does go behind all these things from the programming perspective? So we have two programming perspectives. One is the server-side programming, the other one is the client-side programming. In server-side programming, we generally have programs written on a server which will receive the request, process it, and it displays the pages to the client. So as it is mentioned in the users, it processes the user input, it displays the required pages, structure the web applications which are installed in the web server, and it also interacts with the permanent storage in the form of either SQL or files. So in case you want some binary files, or in case you want some text files as such, all those files actually could be rendered back. So what are the possible languages which are used for server-side scripting is PHP, Java, Visual Basic, C#. So nearly any language could be used for server-side scripting, including the new ones like Python, Ruby on Rails, so on and so forth. These days we have come to a scenario where even JavaScript is also used for server-side programming. So what happens in the client-side programming? Client-side programming is mainly to make the web pages which is sent from the client side more interactive one. Okay, so here basically all the client programs run inside the client. So technically saying that it will run within the browser. So what are the uses of it? It makes the pages very interactive. So as you see a particular image getting loaded, you can ask a progress bar to show as to how much of image is getting loaded. Or in case you want to autofill, you can program it likewise. So you can make stuff happen very dynamically on the web page Along with that, you can also interact with local storage in the form of cookies. So any website we visit, it lives in a small part of cookie, which through which it will identify whether it has this particular laptop or this particular computer has visited that site or not. And it also sends in request to the server, retrieve data from it and render it to the client. And it also provides services for software registration, content delivery and gaming purposes as well. So the examples which are used for client-side programming are primarily JavaScript. Along with that, we make use of HTML and CSS. So these three put together, it makes a very good combination for client-side programming. So let's take a break here, and when we come back, we will look into the introduction to JavaScript.